you trying to say? When we have everything, we will serve God. But will you also serve Him when you don't have anything? Looks like you're thinking right. Let me put it this way. You're forced to come to God when you don't have anything, right? But when you also come to Him when you have everything? Lastly, the Lord says, do you know how you must serve me? Verse 47 is beautiful. Two kinds of worship people speak about, worshipping Him with humility and poverty. Verse 47 beautifully says how we should worship Him. What is the best form of serving Him? For the abundance of everything. Worship Him with joy and gladness. Deuteronomy 28 verse 47. Hallelujah. Clap your hands unto the Lord. Amen. 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 The Lord clearly says, for the abundance of everything, worship Him with joy and gladness. He never said, you must worship me even if you don't have anything. What are you trying to say? When we have everything, we will serve God. But will you also serve Him when you don't have anything? Looks like you're thinking right. Let me put it this way. You're forced to come to God when you don't have anything, right? But will you also come to Him when you have everything? Which has a greater weight? Not coming to God when you don't have anything. Yes, if sickness comes, even a person who doesn't believe in God will start believing. So faith that comes during sickness is not the best. Faith that comes during wilderness experience is not the best. But that which comes when you have an abundance of everything. Clap your hands. This has a greater weightage before God. That has a greater percentage. Praising God in the midst of your problems is not something great. It is good, but it is a second class. But when you have an abundance of everything, praising Him. Not standing in a crowded bus and praying in tongues that I should not get squeezed is a best standard prayer. It is good. Call unto me in the day of trouble. But praising and praying in tongues in your BMW with your AC is more precious. God will say, my son praises me even while enjoying his BMW. Job beautifully writes, you may have gold like stones in the river, but the Almighty Himself will be your gold and choice silver. Job 24 to 26. How much ever blessings may come, we will find delight in the Almighty God. This is the highest class of spiritual life. No one can argue serving God in the midst of poverty is the most noble form of spiritual life. A high class spiritual life is one when we have everything in life but still seeking God above those. Till the will is written, the children are behind the Father. But they should come after the will is written. The son who comes after the will is written is the right son. We come to God after receiving our inheritance, not so that we may receive our inheritance. God has given us everything. We have a surplus, but still we come with joy and praise Him with gladness. Hallelujah. You can read Deuteronomy 28, 15 to 60. You just keep ticking off. This will not come to me. This is not applicable for me. Hallelujah. Praise Him with gladness.